News comes that some have called for a federal investigation into antisemitism on the University of Minnesota campus. Gordon is here now to talk about what is being alleged in this complaint about antisemitism. Hi, Gordon.
Yeah, this complaint centers around a few messages that were posted by professors in the College of Liberal Arts voicing their support for the Palestinian people. The authors of this complaint, however, argue these messages are anti-Israel and anti-Semitic. And since they were posted on university websites, they violate the school's code of conduct and must be taken down.
My concern is just simply that they're using the website. The university's official websites to do this.
Michael Hsu is a former U of M regent.
Yeah.
He says back in October, he and U of M law professor Richard Painter became aware of some pro-Palestinian messages shared by professors on university websites. Painter sent the university this letter asking leadership to condemn these messages for violating the university's official code of conduct. Hsu says the university has refused, so the two men filed the complaint with the U.S. Department of Education, requesting a formal investigation.
It's a form of cyberbullying. It is making people feel unwelcome at the university. And any of these faculty could just easily use their own social media, and they shouldn't be using the university's websites, which are, you know, funded by the government in part.
This complaint is just one of many the Department of Education has received in recent weeks. Since the conflict in the Middle East started on October 7th, the department has received 29 official complaints requesting investigations into universities and K-12 schools across the country. Three university presidents have also come under fire in recent days after they were called to Washington for a hearing on antisemitism and Islamophobia on college campuses. The president at the University of Pennsylvania resigned over the weekend after all the backlash. Students and faculty at Harvard and MIT are also calling for the removal of their presidents. But leaders at both universities say they're standing behind their presidents and don't have any plans to remove them.
The universities are caught in the middle of all this because they want to believe that they can act on academic freedom. But I think if you look closely at the law, that they're probably overstepping.
And it's not just college campuses. Nationwide, there has been a massive increase in reports of antisemitism and Islamophobia in recent weeks. The Anti-Defamation League says over the last 2 months, they have received more than 2,000 complaints, a 337% increase over the same time last year. The Council on American Islamic Relations reports similar numbers with more than 2,100 complaints of anti-Muslim and anti-Palestinian bias since the conflict started.
Now, the professors who posted these messages at the U of M argue they have the right to share these messages due to academic freedom. And in the messages, they do clarify that these are their own personal views and don't reflect the views of the university as a whole. The university has also responded to this complaint, saying, quote, "The letter's broad characterizations of the university are inaccurate and are fundamentally contrary to our mission and our values." And we did post the full statement from the university on our website.
Gordon, I know you were talking about that growing list with the Department of Education, which is where these two men took their complaint. Any other Minnesota universities on it or schools that you found?
No other schools here in Minnesota are included on that list. And actually, this complaint isn't officially on that list yet. I was told by these two gentlemen that they actually just got a message today that says they received it, and it's going to be assigned to someone to work on that case moving forward.
All right, Gordon, thank you so much.